Hey everybody, Star here. What is going on? Today we're going to be doing a little bit of a casual tutorial for rocket jumping. I'm still firmly of the belief that if you are at all interested in rocket jumping whatsoever, there are a ton of amazing guides already out there that you just need to search for, and if I show off anything in this video that you guys want to see more of, I am positive that you can find more about it. A great resource is tf2jump.com. It has pretty much everything that you need to know about the TF2 Jump community, a list of servers which you can practice on that have jump maps all ready for you to go on. But instead of finding ourselves on some fancy jump map that is specifically designed for jumping around on it, we find ourselves here on good old stock Badlands, where we can take some of the things that we do learn from TF2 jump maps and apply it to an actual map. And this is actually where I started most of my personal rocket jump training, on a map that I understood, that I know that I would play on, and that if I learned anything on this map, I could transfer it over to an actual server and play around on it. And one of the first jumps that I wanted to learn how to do was to jump from this location right here to the spire on the other side of the map, because I had seen a video of someone doing it, I saw how they did it, and I understood that it was possible, so I thought I would just try and replicate what they did as many times as possible, and just keep doing it over and over again until I completely understand what it is that they were doing and how they were doing it. Unfortunately, we messed that jump up a little bit right there, but that's fine, it happens, and that brings up the first point, that after doing this tons and tons of times, the first thing that I learned before I learned anything about rocket jumping is that when you do this a lot, you're going to be dying and reloading a lot, and this is a custom created server where I can practice in peace. But one thing that really helps is I can just type exec jump, and that's going to buff me back up to full health, full ammo, and it is an amazing resource for just practicing by yourself, because I really would just do this for hours and hours at a time, and stopping to pick up health packs and ammo, even if you are using the rocket jumper and taking fall damage, it's something that you can't really bother yourself with, and it's just nice to be able to jump, and jump, and hey look, I made it, maybe not to the actual top of Spire, but we're pretty much here. Despite personally sitting around and learning how to do that jump, I almost never use it. It's kind of ridiculous, and it's one of those ones that, you know, why bother? But there actually is a variation of that jump on this map which I use all of the time, jumping off of this wall right here, coming from a respawn or something like that, which allows me to get to Spire much more quickly with just two jumps, and it is, once again, just skipping off the top of one of these crates. And if you understand the concepts from the first jump, maybe you can add a little bit more onto this one. Say your team is fighting on the last control point, and you need to get there a little bit faster rather than Spire. You can add one more jump and chain it in there, and it's quite viable because there's even a health pack here when you get there. Alright, I can understand that rocket jumping is useful sometimes, but what I don't understand is how to do the jumps that you're doing. Well, this jump right here, it's on a map that we all know, and it teaches a lot of very important concepts, but we're gonna take a step back for a second, and we're gonna talk about some of those important concepts that we really need to know and understand before we even try and tackle this one right here. And the most important, the most crucial, is strafing while we're in the air, and we don't need to leave home to show this off and test it a little bit. What we're gonna do is enable SV Cheats 1, that can give us SV Gravity is 200, and then what we're gonna do is jump into the air, and we're going to strafe around Spire, going all the way around it, doing, you know, our loop-de-loops through the air. Doing this is actually relatively simple, and it will become second nature once you get used to it, but first you have to get used to it, and there are some important habits that you should be building before you really start trying to do this the wrong way. And what you're going to want to do to strafe is really, it's very simple. We're going to be strafing around the high tower right here, and all we're going to do while we're in the air is touch the D key to move right, and then we're slowly going to move our mouse to guide ourselves around it. That's all we're going to touch, that's all we're going to do. So regular rocket jump, touching the D key, slowly moving my mouse to the right, and we made it pretty much around the high tower there. One thing that you never want to do while you're in there, and this is the habit that you need to break, is you do not want to touch the W key. It is a very common habit to say, I'm moving forward, I want to hold down W at all times to go faster. You don't want to do that. That is going to reduce how you can move your character around the air greatly. And the important thing to keep in mind here is the rocket is propelling you forward. You don't even need to think about going forward, because you've gotten all the momentum you've gotten from doing this. I'm touching nothing right now. I'm going forward. I'm going to die. Perfecting this is incredibly important. Once you get it down, there is no rocket jump that you are ever going to do where you aren't going to need a little bit of strafing. So get it down as soon as you can. Good luck. The one exception to the rule, because there always is an exception to the rule, is you want to use the W key so that you can stay up against walls when you are climbing walls. I'm going to let go of the W key now, and you're going to see it bounces me far enough back that I can't continue going up the wall anymore. So W key, only useful for climbing walls, and also walking. So, moving on to the next concept, we have pogo jumping, being able to bounce up and down very closely to the floor without ever actually touching the floor, and speed pogoing, a variant of that that allows you to skip very quickly across the floor. When I first began doing TF2 jump service, I have to tell you, I absolutely dreaded any form of pogo jump whatsoever. I just could not see the points on why I would ever need to learn how to bounce up and down in one spot and slowly move across an obstacle. When are you ever going to use that? You don't even have enough rockets to use that in an actual match, but in actuality, it does teach you a lot of concepts that are important for jumps that are really fun to do. Speed pogoing has actually become one of my favorite things to do in rocket jumping, and it really is a shame that I put it off for so long and didn't want to learn it because it appeared so boring and pointless to me. And I know a lot of people feel the same way about pogo jumps, and as someone who was there, I've been there, I appreciate the fact that I took the time to learn how to pogo a little bit, and it really is crucial when you're doing an awesome rocket jump and you want to chain jumps together and you need to skip really quickly across the floor, having an appropriate understanding of how the boring stuff works will come in handy. There are tons of ways to initiate a pogo jump or to chain into them, however you want to start a pogo jump, but here's one really simple way to start one off, where you could just stand still, jump up into the air, let yourself hover for a brief moment, and then fire a rocket directly underneath you, and you could just literally hold down the left click button and continuously do this. And as you're stuck in this perpetual state of rocket jump, you can begin shimmying yourself along the ground, gaining a little bit more speed. Another way to initiate this with a little bit more haste is just to crouch and shoot a rocket behind you without actually jumping, giving yourself a little bit of boost, and that will start initiating the pogos, giving you a bit more speed to start. Usually TF2 jump maps will start you off on a platform and you need to fall down and pogo yourself across a little ways, and usually these platforms are the perfect height where you can just fall off and crouch and start shooting the ground immediately and you will find yourself within a pogo. It just takes a little bit of practice and understanding when to start it, and it really is just all about the timing. But yeah, that is a little bit boring, so we're here on Man vs. Machine, where I can upgrade my rocket jumper to shoot as fast as I want, so I can pogo as fast as I want. What I'd like to point out to you guys is that when you start doing a very fast pogo, or you want to hit a fast pogo chaining from another jump, you have to aim significantly further in front of you. You're no longer aiming down perfectly at the ground as you were before. You are moving faster than your rocket, so you need to shoot that rocket ahead of you so you can hit it as you're coming up to it. And this as well, it really is, you just need to know the timing, have some practice with it so you can expect this. One more really fun thing about speed pogoing is that if you are very low to the ground and moving very fast and you hit a slanted surface, you are going to slide up that and continue your rocket jump. You can market garden people after this because you have never technically touched the ground and you are still in a rocket jumping state. Another thing that's pretty similar to that is gliding across the top of water. As long as you're holding down your jump button while you're over the water, you will just, you know, glide right over it. It's pretty cool. So here, once again, we find ourselves on CP Badlands, talking about the jump we did at the very beginning of this video, and we're gonna break it down step by step. Now that we've learned some various rocket jumping mechanics, we can see how they all apply to this jump one at a time. Where you actually fire your rocket on this wall is very important. It is a regular rocket jump where you just jump up into the air, crouch, and then shoot, except instead of shooting the ground, you're shooting the wall. And if you fire too low, you're gonna go way too high over the crate and there isn't even a potential chance to shoot the pogo. If you shoot too high up on the wall, clearly you're just putting yourself into the ground. You wanna get it just the perfect height where you barely skim across the top and it sets you up perfectly for that next pogo jump. If that jump goes well and you glide right over the top of the crates, the next one is going to be very easy, and all you really need to do is shoot down at the crate as you're going over it, and the speed from the first jump will carry you over. Strafing while in the air is very important for this jump. It may be subtle and you may not really be able to see big giant turns in the air, but as soon as I jump off of this wall right here, I'm going to be strafing towards the right, very subtly leaning myself this way to line myself up for the next jump so I'm facing the next crate. I can make sure I hit that, and then after hitting this crate, you want to very slightly strafe to the left so you can avoid this invisible wall that's actually right here. For the third jump, you're going to want to aim a little bit more ahead of yourself because you are going faster now, but if the first two jumps went well, chances are this one's going to go pretty good as well. The real problem comes after this one. The fourth jump is by far the most difficult jump in this entire set. You're going very fast now, so you need to fire your rocket early, and you also need to time it perfectly. Oh yeah, and this tiny little crack that's right here, you're gonna get stopped by that. You'd normally be able to surf right over this and it'd be pretty fantastic, but that tiny little thing is gonna mess you up on occasion. I know I'm speaking blasphemy here, but if CP Badlands were ever to be changed in any way, I would really like to see that gone. However, when you finally do hit that fourth jump just right, the results can be pretty spectacular. The unfortunate part about that is, I don't have too many tips about this fourth one. When you're going at insane speeds like this, it really just comes down to how much you've practiced, how well you get the timing down, and sometimes on servers with a little bit of latency, it does come down to luck sometimes. The super big secret behind becoming good at rocket jumping, becoming good at anything, is always just you need a lot of patience, you need to practice a lot. You should know what your rocket jump is going to do before you even do it. And the only way you can be in a position like that is if you've had a lot of experience doing rocket jumps previously. Just messing up before, not being able to do it, all leads to you being able to do it. However, I'd encourage anybody, if you have the time to learn it and you're interested in it at all, you know, go ahead, jump in, learn how to do the jumps. Soldier isn't my favorite class in Team Fortress 2, but rocket jumping is one of my favorite things to do in any game in existence, really. Even for people who are experienced at jumping, there is still more to experience, there is still more to learn, and if there's a map you haven't jumped on before, well, you need to learn what specific things you can do on that map. There is planning, and there is a bit of creativity to come up with the jump in the first place. Or, well, once again, more experience if you saw somebody do it and you were inspired to try it. So all I can say to conclude this, go gain the experience, and then go use it. It's really as simple as that. There are a lot of things I didn't cover in this video because it really is a complex subject. And if you'd enjoyed it, I appreciate it. I'll catch you all next time. Peace out, everybody.